to speak. I would like to focus on the problems the Universal Credit actually faced in Warrington South. As the Minister will be aware, Warrington was one of the pathfinder areas in the North West where Universal Credit has been introduced since 2013. And as such, we are already seeing the severe consequences of the government's mishandling of Universal Credit in our communities. Madam Deputy Speaker, it is often the most vulnerable in our society that are most affected by the failures of programs such as Universal Credit. Indeed, low-income individuals and families are some of those who have been hit the hardest. The annual report from Warrington Food Bank highlighted that in 2016 and 17, there was a 13.9% increase in the number of meals delivered upon the previous year. Volunteers and trustees at the food bank found that this increase was directly linked to the full rollout of Universal Credit in the town. Research found that 48% of the 56,000 meals that were given out by Warrington Food Bank went to individuals suffering from benefit changes or delays, and over 34% of these meals went to children. These situations are unacceptable and unsustainable. Government failures are putting people at increased risk of eviction and of visits from bailiffs. Madam Deputy Speaker, and the help that is offered in the form of government advances is given with repayment rates that are unaffordable to many. The stated aim of Universal Credit to make work pay, to encourage individuals back into work. But I would like the government to consider today, if people have nowhere to live and nothing to eat, how can we expect them to get a job? Universal Credit is simply not fit for purpose, and government must pause the rollout of Universal Credit for services. Thank you.
Well done.